sudari wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli yafqahu qawli. Honorable of the teachers, honorable the juries of the contest, honorable all the participants and all of the audience. First of all, let us pray and thanks to our God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has given us His mercy and blessing. So, we are able to attend this place in healthy condition and good situation. Second, may salawat and salam be with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his parents and followers, who has guided us from the darkness into the brightness era by saying, Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. So, I don't forget to say thank you very much to the master of ceremony who has given me the time to deliver my speech out of the title, The Rule of Youth in Improving Reading Habit. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now in the industrial 4.0 era, the era of globalization, which is so fast that can undermine the community of young people to submit to technology. Let's look around us. Whether it's your friends, your sister, your brother, your son, your daughter, your parents, and even yourself are now people who buy phone rather than you. As we know, children, especially students at present, they are very lazy to be, very lazy to PC lately. Why is that? Because they prefer playing games and something on social media rather than reading books. Prefer another things rather than books. It is very alarming. A study conducted by Central Connecticut State University in 2016 in the most literate nation in the world states that Indonesia ranks 60th out of the total 61 countries surveyed. Reading interest of Indonesian people is only 0.01% or 1 in 10,000. Imagine 1 in 10,000. From 10,000 of Indonesian people, only 1% would like to read. The irony is, this number is inversely proportional to the number of internet users, which reaches half of Indonesia's total population or around 132.7 million people. Ladies and gentlemen, whereas, as Muslim we know from the Holy Quran, the Jibril asked our great Prophet Muhammad to read as his first commandment. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Iqra' bismi rabbikal ladzi khalaq. Read, and read by the name of Allah who created. And a wise man said that book is the window of the world and reading is the key. But how we can increase the reading habit? What can we do? As young generations of Indonesia, it's our duty to change the society habit. Why should we? Why not our parents, our teachers, or even our government? Our first president, the proclamator of Indonesia, Insinyur Soekarno, said, "Give me 1,000 adults, I will take Semeru from its root. Give me 10 youths, I will save the world." It is as a self-respect for you. Where youth has any further rule in the development of the nation. Youth is agents of community mobilization in governing regional and national ideas. Indonesian youth is the future of the nation. Therefore, every Indonesian youth, both those who are still students or who have completed their education, are important actors who are very reliable to realize the ideals of enlightening our nation's life in the future. All my friends, as students, let's change our world by reading. By reading, we can start to like reading by ourselves. If in the past, we are lazy in reading, lazy in visiting library, going to referee. Let's change our behaviors. Let's visit our referees. Don't let them referee the lonely dog reading activity. Let's go to our referee and have a look. Our brighter future is there. Because our future, the Indonesian future, is on our hands, young generation. Let's make our country better and better from a small step. The bigger changes below the reading. By reading, we can enlarge our knowledge and information. If Indonesian society are reading lovers, of course, our country will be much better. Because our country needs smart people to face the coming problems. Ladies and gentlemen, before I finish my speech, I'd like to say, happy reading and the smart generation. I think that's all my speech for today. Thank you very much for your nice attention. And forgive me for any mistakes. Finally, I say, Assalamualaikum.